Our next inductee is described as having a brilliant legal mind. In fact, he was so well regarded, he earned a spot on the state's highest court without ever having been a lower court judge. Charles Talley Wells was born March 4th, 1939, right here in Orlando. The son of an attorney and school teacher, he grew up on Lake Jenny Jewel on Gatlin Avenue. It was an idyllic childhood, spent fishing, swimming, and water skiing. Charlie started school at Pine Castle Elementary, which was very rural at the time. He remembers that many of the students didn't wear shoes, so Charlie took his off when he got there every day. His mother, though, wasn't amused after he lost several pairs of shoes. The following year, Charlie's mom moved him to Delaney School, where he formed lifelong friendships that endure today. He went on to Cherokee Junior High and then Boone High School. Charlie was an excellent student, an athlete. He was the captain of the basketball team, which was a lifelong love. We've also been told by some of his longtime friends that even though they didn't quite understand how, Charlie always had the prettiest girlfriends. And he even managed to date girls from other schools like Edgewater and Winter Park. Charlie graduated from Boone High School in 1957 and followed in his father and older brother's footsteps to the University of Florida, where he was active in campus politics and was a member of Phi Delta Theta fraternity. He graduated in 1961 and spent about a year and a half in the Army Reserves before returning to Florida and going to law school. When he graduated in 1965, he had one of the top three scores on the bar exam. He practiced law in Orlando for a few years, but then decided to spread his wings and took a job at the Justice Department in Washington, D.C. That's where he began dating Linda Fisher, a casual acquaintance from UF, who was working in D.C. and also attending law school. They married in 1969 and decided to move back to Orlando. After an unsuccessful run for the state legislature in 1970, Charlie settled into private practice in Orlando, founding Wells, Gaddis, and Howells. He was a trial lawyer with a firm for almost 20 years before being appointed to the Florida Supreme Court by Governor Lawton Childs in 1994. He served as Chief Justice of the Court from 2000 to 2002, when he presided over the Bush versus Gore election cases stemming from the 2000 presidential election. Justice Wells faced a mandatory retirement from the Supreme Court after his 70th birthday in 2009. Since then, he's returned to private practice in Orlando at Gray Robinson. Charlie and Linda have been married for 49 years. And have three children, a son and daughter, who are both attorneys, and another daughter who's a medical doctor. Justice Wells has also served as a role model for the students of the law magnate at Boone High School. In fact, the classroom courtroom at the school was named the Honorable Chief Justice Charles T. Wells Courtroom in his honor.
I have known Charlie, Lord have mercy, it's going on 60 years. And so I can tell you that this is a worthy inductee. Charlie has been publicly spirited all of his life. I saw him do that as a student servant at the University of Florida. And I've seen his service continue throughout his life.
I would say he's the consummate professional in his field, and he's a complete gentleman. When you get to know him, he's just so unassuming for someone with such a high skill level.
Charlie was an excellent student, I mean, there's no doubt about it. He was right at the top of the class.
He is very thoughtful. He doesn't make any quick decisions. He thinks about it before he speaks. He thinks about it before he makes a decision. And he thinks about it before he gives advice.
He has a great sense of humor. Great sense of humor. Always has a smile on his face. He's always grinning. He's just a delight to be around. I got a call right after the governor had appointed Charlie, and so I called him to congratulate him. And we were going back and forth at one another, and I said, well, I presume we're still on a first name basis. And he said, well, you know, I've changed my name. I said, really, what is it? He said, Justice. I said, well, whatever you say, but you're still Charlie. You know, and he laughed.
Mr. Chief Justice, Charlie, good friend, congratulations on being inducted into the Hall of Fame.
He represents what public education can really produce. And for that, I'm thankful. The country is thankful. Congratulations, Charlie.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Justice Charles Wells.
Well, my goodness, I am really totally overwhelmed by the opportunity to be here and overwhelmed by all of you being present. You know, I look out and I see so many people that I have known over the years, and I appreciate more than I can say your friendships. I know that members of our Sunday school class at First Methodist, the new class, have turned out in great number. Frank and Laura Gilbert are so meaningful to our school system, and they are equally as meaningful to our Sunday school class. You know, wherever I go, it seems that when I was sworn in as the Chief Justice of the Florida Supreme Court, I looked out and there were five Methodist ministers in the crowd. And I said on that occasion, you know, that demonstrates how much work there has to be done on my soul, obviously. But I also appreciate Charlie Gray's comments tonight. Charlie has been a friend of mine since I first started at the university. And when I left the court in 2009 and came back to Orlando, Charlie invited me to come down to Gray Robinson, and it's been a great experience there. But I'm truly, Charlie is an example of what can be done in so many ways for this community by someone that puts their shoulders to the wheel. And Charlie's been doing that all of my adult career. I look out and there's so many more community leaders here. And I saw Jim Pugh, who by his initiative has built the Dr. Phillips Center. And isn't that a magnificent thing for our community? But you know, let me say that in September 1935, almost 83 years ago, my brother Joel stepped into Delaney Elementary. And thus began the Wells family being absorbed within the caring, the nurturing, the counseling, the educating, the discipline and love of the Orange County Public Schools. When Joel began, our parents lived 11 East Miller Street, which is now part of the Orlando Regional Medical Center. By the time I began in 1945, as you heard, my parents had moved out to Gatlin Avenue, which was definitely in the boonies. And so I started at Pinecastle. And as they also said, one of the things that happened at Pinecastle was that none of the kids weren't wearing shoes, which was great with me. But it wasn't so great with my mother. And after I took several shoes off and put them in the bushes and lost them, I found myself at Delaney. And so, and I look back on the fact that through going to Delaney Elementary School and Cherokee Junior High School and then Boone High School, that I made friends who have been with me every step of the way in my life. And the public schools were meaningful to me in that way. But when I was told that I was going to be the proud recipient of this award, it caused me to go back through my mind's eye of all of the blessings that I have received from the Orange County Public Schools. And I can see Mrs. Gulliver at Delaney Elementary School, who was a longtime principal there, Mrs. Ellington, who was my fourth and fifth grade teacher, Ms. Payne, my sixth grade teacher, and Mr. Gilly, who also was a sixth grade teacher. I went over to Cherokee, and Mr. Bookhart was the principal at Cherokee. And I can see, like it's today, Jim Wiggins, who was the football coach there, and Bob Brumfield, who was the baseball coach. And then I went to Boone. And at Boone, I can see in my mind's eye Ms. McMakin, Ms. McIntyre, Ms. Meyer, who was the principal, Mr. Jolly, who was our chemistry teacher, Mr. Kirst, who was a great math teacher, Nobie Simpson, who not only taught Latin when I was at Boone, she taught Latin when my brother Joel was at Orlando High School. Rumor was she knew Julius Caesar personally. I can see Coach Jim Baines. Jim Baines often told me something that turned out to be predictive. He said, if you don't start playing better, you're going to end up on the bench. Coach Harry Mizell, George Fody. You know, tonight I'm here with my family, who have likewise been blessed by our public schools. My wife and in-house counsel, Linda, who went to the public schools in Pinellas County. Our daughter, Shelley Wells Collins, and Ashley Wells Cox, and Ashley's children and her husband Jeremy are with us. And Linda and I often comment with awe and gratitude about how superb the public schools of Orange County, Windermere Elementary, Lakeview Middle, and West Orange High prepared our children for later academic success. Our son Tally, who couldn't be here tonight, but he is now a lawyer and executive director of Appleseed, a nonprofit in Atlanta, was prepared to be an honors graduate of Duke in both undergraduate and law school. Shelley was prepared to be an honors undergraduate at Wake Forest and a graduate of the University of Miami Medical School, and is now a pediatrician and the medical director of the Children's Hospital at Shands. And Ashley was prepared to be a high honors graduate, both undergraduate at Duke and at Northwestern Law School, because of the foundation that they were given at the Orange County Public Schools. So I tell you, it's no wonder that I am overwhelmed by this honor, and that I have such a debt of gratitude to the Orange County Public School System. I had occasion this week to read again Article 9, Section 1 of our state constitution, which says, "The education of children is a fundamental value of the people of the state of Florida. It is therefore a paramount duty of the state to make adequate provision for the education of all children residing within its borders. Adequate provision shall be made by law for a uniform, efficient, safe, secure, high-quality system of free public schools. We have to expend every effort and overcome every obstacle to enforce this provision and hold those that are in positions of responsibility to account for their having done so. Thank you so much.